the second time I've seen that person fly by at, I don't know, what is that, 200 miles an hour or something? Clearly using some exploit. Yeah, whoever this is, took him less than 6 seconds to go across this gap. To get a power up before going into the event. That's something to start with. Generally helps. I think it retains the power up when you join. Let's see. Nope, they must have removed that. Used to be able to retain it when you joined the event, but it seems like they fixed that. I don't know if it was a bug necessarily, but it was something they used to allow anyway. Normally I'd be blasting music while I do this, but I think that I get in trouble with YouTube's copyright stuff for doing that. So I have to do these races in silence. It's brutal. I switched to a different streaming strategy. Last week, where I'm streaming from my computer, it's on my iPad now. But when I was on my iPad, I used a different streaming app called Omelette Arcade, and it would push notifications of chat that I got in the YouTube live stream to my iPad, so you could kind of see the chat that way. But with the new streaming software that I'm using, it doesn't push the chat to the gaming window. And I know there's a way to do it, I just haven't messed with it yet. But so, yeah, you can chat on the YouTube live stream, which Justin Carver, my teammate, is doing. He's giving me shit, because last week he said that I turned chat off, which I accidentally did for a couple of minutes. So they will be able to troll me this week. A lot of my teammates are doing the other races, the B and C races, and those races are shorter. So they finish before the A race, and then some of my teammates tune in to my live stream after their races are done, or even during their races, to snoop on me and troll a little bit, which they're particularly good at. See, 7-ish minutes till start. This is what my avatar looks like today. Just trying to show the kit. Maybe it's better done by choosing a frame. There we go. Yeah, there's the kit I'm wearing today. It's a blue, pink socks, no helmet. I believe B is Brandon McNulty, maybe. So a pro rider, rides for UAE Team Emirates on the World Tour. Nathan Brown is also a pro rider. He got, let's see. He got booted from the race last week for riding unrealistically, according to Zwift, which, I mean, I don't know the guy personally or how strong he is, but if he's a pro, it probably means he's capable of tripping the Zwift thresholds for, like, what is humanly possible, I guess. So they may have booted him for that. A lot of the pros, like Lawson Craddock, they get little pro tags on their name, and then that, I think, increases the threshold for banning them from a race. So he might not have been granted that exception yet. Hopefully he fixed it this week so he doesn't get banned this week. Yeah, so the cone of shame, or cone of fame, whatever you want to call it, is a little like warning triangle that gets placed over the top of your avatar whenever Zwift thinks you're riding unrealistically. So getting coned is like the vernacular for having your watts restricted by Zwift, because they don't think that that's a legitimate performance. Which there's a lot of people in this race who could probably exceed Zwift's threshold for what is perceived as a legitimate performance. So we'll see who joins this week. Last week we had Magnus Sheffield, who spent a lot of time riding off the front. He is a junior world champion road racer who I believe, signed with the World Tour Pro Team. He's going to skip the U23 ranks. Basically, junior, I think, is 18 and under. And then there's the U23, which is kind of like the feeding grounds to like the actual World Tour Pro ranks. And I guess you can skip those. It's kind of like skipping, like, playing college ball to go directly to pros, which, you know, if you're on top of your game, you can compete at that level, and for an athlete, it's probably a good idea, because if that's your prime years, then you don't want to skip those by not getting paid as much as you could playing college ball or U23 or whatever. So more power to him if he can skip up there. Yeah, I see he's in this race as well today. M. Sheffield at the bottom, you can see. So, yeah, a couple of these guys that can push over 5 watts per kilogram, that's, my voice sounds so distant. Yeah. Hey, Michael Cheney in here as well. My Bobs. yeah, I don't know how to make my voice sound better. There's a lot of, like, noise filters and stuff, noise gates I'm using to try to, keep the trainer noise low and the fan noise low. I would mess with it, but with 3 minutes to start, I'm afraid of messing something up, so I think it's okay, even if you can't really hear what I'm saying. But Christy Tracy in this race as well. She's been doing a lot of the pro women's races on Zwift, and her team, Team Infinite, has also been doing very well in those races. Christy's been a big part of helping them there. She was a local races driveway with us down here in Austin, Texas. Very strong rider. She also live streams most of these races generally. Pete Barrett, I'm wondering if that's Patrick Barrett, used to work at National Instruments. Probably used to race driveway when he lived here. He moved out to California, I believe, worked for a different company. He's got some family that still works at NI. It's funny how small and big the cycling community is. Got 15 seconds to start. Break up the watts here. Always a fast start.
Hi, Jackie. Lawson's taunting us, asking if we're gonna race. There goes an attack. Maybe. Magnus trying to coordinate a breakaway with Nate. I think it's kind of a joke, maybe. Thank you. Here's an attack from Lawson. Keep that reeled in. There he goes again. I chased that last one, someone else is gonna have to do this one. Thank you. My sister said in YouTube comments, her husband walked by and said, "Go Joel." Thank you, Walt. My boss is hoping I get first. Haha, good luck. Good luck to me. So, about halfway through the race, and the pace calmed down quite a bit. Much smaller group than we had before. Waiting for the next attacks. There goes one now, from Lawson. That was probably dumb. Yeah, that was dumb. Lawson's trolling us. Said, y'all ever heard of a counterattack? Well, most of us are riding on our limit. I don't know about him. Thanks, Mom. Lawson's calling out Zimmerman. Zimmerman's a sprinter. He's one of the Crow Zwifters esports guys. Batting for Evoke. He might have won last week, I'm not sure. Lawson's trying to bait him to attack, but he won't. My sister's asking me if I change my kit color, she can't figure out who I am. I've got him an aqua jersey, black shorts, pink socks, orange bike. The camera stays focused on me. I'm off to the left side of the pack right now. Now I'm in the center. No helmet. Is an attack. Thank you. actually know if we caught Lawson or not. Oh yeah, he's there. We got him. Magnus shut him down, which is kind of funny. Confirmed, Brandon McNulty is B. Arrow helmet, I'll probably keep this for the sprint finish if I can. See, there's a group up ahead. I don't know if that's lapped riders or if that's a breakaway. I think it's lapped riders. Thank you. Game on, last lap. It's like Sheffield one today. Good for him. I am pretty happy with that. Another local buddy, Dan Pedroza, coming in. Riding my wheel. Couple of pros right after that. Bunch of pros. I'm very happy with that. I might get a... Oh no, I thought I was gonna get points. Top seven gets points. Oh, I was in eighth. I got moved to ninth, I guess. Okay. That's alright. At least they let me sprint today. That was cool. Usually they drag race from so far out. I need to get a chance to sprint. This sprint definitely favored like a lighter weight rider. Because it had a uphill kick right before the finish. So if you can keep a good steady watts per kilogram high through that hill,
and roll that into a flat out sprint. You don't necessarily need as many watts if you're first over that hill. But that was nice. That was good. Well, thanks for watching, y'all. Thanks, Chaney. Thanks, family. Thanks, teammates. Hit like and subscribe. All the plug stuff. You got it. All right. Thanks, guys. Bye.